It was all in God's plan.
It was all in God's plan.
The subtitle of my message today is Push, Press, Touch. Look at your neighbor on today and begin to say push.
Push.
Press.
Press.
And touch.
Touch.
What push is an act of force. Okay. Or someone or something in order to move them away from oneself. Shove, rub, nudge, bump, or bump. Okay. Uh-huh. That's what a push is. Mm-hmm. Press is applying pressure. Sometimes it's a pressure going on in your life. Come on. Touch is to fasten to. In Greek, it means to start a fire. Mm-hmm. Yesterday we preached on consuming fire.
Yes.
The touch you guys will see through this message is what God showed me that his touch is his Holy Spirit that flows through you like never ever before. When God begins to touch your body.
Amen. Hallelujah.
All right. So, if we go back to let's go to 25. And a certain woman, which had issues of blood 12 years, begin to ask your neighbor, what am I struggling with? What am I dealing with? What can I break free with on today? What is troubling me?
Come on, come on.
I believe that her name was not important. Her identity was not important because you can begin to implement yourself. So yeah, I can say, Rita, what am I struggling with?
Yeah, right. Yeah.
What have I been struggling with that has held me down? Because everybody has issues. Ask your neighbor, do you have some issues?
Come on, come on.
Because nobody be perfect unless they be the Father. And he without sin cast the first stone. And it says, let me give you a little history of the lady with the issue of blood and where she came from. Where she came from was a place that worshiped false gods, that killed people. This place that she was from, they set up idols. They had wild living. Can you relate to that?
All right.
Amen.
Let's keep it real.
Amen to that.
So, 26 and said, and has suffered many things of many physicians, and has spent all that she had, and was nothing better but weather grew worse. What you spending your money on? A lot of times we have so much pain, and we try to cover it up with drugs, alcohol, relationships, unsaveness. But why don't we just begin to go to God for the answers that we need in life?
That's right.
Yes. If it says seek you first the kingdom of heaven and all righteousness and all these things will be added unto you, why are we going here, there, going to our cousins, our friends, and our family and asking them what a such thing?
Yeah. All right.
What should I do about this? What should I do about that?
All right.
Instead of seeking the beginning and the end, the author and the finisher of our faith.
Right. Amen.
27 says, when she had heard of Jesus, came in the press behind and touched his garment. Why are we not touching God?
Come on.
And begin to just say, God, have your way with my life. Enter into me. Make me whole, make me complete. Take everything out of me that is not of you.
Yes, Lord.
28, for she said, if I may touch but his clothes, I shall be made whole. I'm here to tell you all today, the things that you are struggling with, if you begin to lay in God's presence and just begin to just wholeheartedly say, God, save me. God, touch me. God touched you. You have a direct connection with the Father. But when you at home, you can begin to just praise God like never ever before. Because some of you guys been going to different places, different churches for healing. But God said, I'm ready to heal you right now.
Come on.
You begin to
Yeah.
To just search and seek after me.
Come on.
I'll heal you.
Yes.
God said, by ye stripes I am healed. But what happens is we don't want to go into God's word and we don't want to seek what God has said about these things and call his word back to him that should never come back void. So we begin to just settle what the doctors tell us. We seek in our body. And we begin to believe these things. And one door after one door opens to another door. And one sickness comes into our bodies, then another sickness comes into our body. Because of things that we are accepting for our life. Verse 28 says, for she said, I'm sorry, verse 29, and straightway the fountain of her blood was dried up, and she felt in her body that she was healed of this plague. How many people know that a blood washing ceremony has taken place? When you begin to take God's blood for your blood and believe in God, then a blood washing takes place. So that you can be made whole. You don't have to accept that no more.
Come on.
So begin to tell your neighbor, I don't have to do that no more. I don't have to go to those places no more.
I don't have to do that anymore.
I'm healed already.
Come on.
I'm healed already. I'm not trying to say, why am I crying at night?
Right.
If you're crying at night, you need to reach out for God and say, God, heal my body. Touch me. I need a touch from you, oh God. I need to heal my mind on today. Take the sadness away from me. You ain't got to call your best friend on the phone.
Amen.
God's got it.
That's it.
And Jesus, immediately knowing in him that the virtue has gone out of his body, turned him about in the press. The press.
Amen.
And said, who touched my clothes?
Because
something happens when you touch God. Something happens when you enter into his presence.
Hallelujah.
You begin to just lay before him and say, God, here I am, Lord. Here I am, Lord. Clean me up.
Yes.
You don't have to go to physicians no more about fake things and put your faith in him.
That's right.
You can go to the doctor, but don't let the doctor be your last resort. Begin to press into God and say, God, for you I live. You are that.
Come on.
You know what's going on with
me. Amen.
Hallelujah.
31. And his disciples said unto him, thou seest the woman who dug at them and saying, It's kind of funny how people around you all the time. There's people in your life right now that when you cross over and get saved, they gonna miss it. Cause they gonna think that you the same person that you used to be, and they gonna say, tomorrow she be getting drunk.
Come on.
Tomorrow she gonna be getting
Yes,
tomorrow she may be cussing somebody else, but they don't understand that salvation is real. It doesn't happen overnight. But as long as we press towards the presence of God and ask him to deliver us and save us, he's a just God.
Amen. Hallelujah.
And he looked around and about to see her that had done this thing. 32 says, and see her. See, God sees you right where you are.
That's right.
God is looking at you right where you are. Right where you are. God sees you. But you know what I like about God? People will judge you, but God judges the heart. People will say, she ain't never going to be nothing. She dumb and stupid. She going to be a plucker all my life. She going to be a prostitute. She going to be this person. She going to be that person all your life. But how many people know that only God can judge me? And it's only God can judge me and see me for who I am. I don't need you to tell me who I am. I don't need you to talk about me. I don't need you to tell your friends who you think I am. Because the only thing that matters to me is who God says. If I'm pleasing to God, guess what? You don't even matter. Tell your neighbor today, you don't matter. Who God says. 33. But the woman, fearing and trembling, knowing what was done in her, came and fell down before him and told him all the truth.
That's right.
Who you owe the truth to?
God.
God.
That's right.
Because every time you try to justify yourself to man, it seems like you can never be good enough for man.
Right.
If somebody is very wrong on today, that's trying to please everybody else.
Come on here.
I'm going to talk to you about me for a minute.
Come on.
For a long time, I wanted to be a people pleaser. I wanted to please everybody around me that didn't they didn't have a heaven or hell to put me in, but I was worried because they was always talking about me. They always had something to say every time I turned my back. But God is saying on today, only person you have to worry about is what I think, what I say, what my will is. But it's kind of sad because you got some people that don't even care about what God says about
you. Know it.
They won't even get in their word to see what thus says the Lord says. So they find themselves in uncomfortable situations, tossed to and fro. Because they can't find out who they are. It's no name, but it's message because it's an identity message. Because some of you guys in here are in an identity crisis. Because you have not sought after God and you want to seek after people and you want to run after people and things that you think that these things are going to justify you. But it's nothing but God that can heal you, save you, and set you free and tell you who you are. But then it says in 34. And he said unto her daughter, thy faith has made thee whole. Go in peace and be whole of this plea.
Come on, come on.
This thing that you're going through right now today. You need to begin to just go into God's presence and say, God, touch me. God, touch me. Heal me. Deliver me. My mind on today. Because sometimes what the devil does is he keeps your mind so bombarded that you don't even know what's going on, which way to go, what to do, what to say. But if we will begin to just pray over our minds and say, let this mind be awesome in Christ Jesus. Reform my mind on today. Renew my mind. Renew my thinking on today. Oh God, open up my ears on today so I can begin to hear a word from you on today. Oh God, stir it up deep in my belly so that it begins to spew out of my mouth like never ever before.
Hallelujah.
Because although Jesus was on a different mission and a different assignment to go heal somebody, something touched him. But the problem is, we're not trying to get into the presence of God so we can even feel his touch.
Help.
It's something about God. It's just something about God. If you begin to just push. Tell your neighbor, just begin to push.
Just push.
Thank you, Lord.
Stop putting your trust in man and everybody else that you see. Because they can't help you. You see this girl, this lady with the issue of blood. She was weak, breathless, hardly able to walk. Her body started to hemorrhage. She was ceremonially unclean because of this illness that she had. Everything and everybody that she touched would have been made unclean. But what are you touching? What are you doing that's unclean on today? We need to begin to come to the altar and just lay aside everything and tell God to work on us. Can I be real? Or this week I had to tell God to work on my anger and my temper and the way that I am so that I can rest in his presence. But it's a lot of things that we need help with, but we don't even want to get in his presence and say, God, help me. I need a blood washing. Even though we know that the blood washing, when the virtue went out of Jesus' garment, what it was the Holy Spirit that came about of him. But you don't even want to get in his presence so the Holy Spirit can get up in you and consume like the consuming fire that we talked about last night, which is the Holy Spirit. So we don't say, Holy Spirit coming to me like never ever before, save me. We'd rather run and go hide. That was what's wrong with Adam and Eve. When they sinned, they hid themselves because they were naked. But the nakedness was, I was wrapped in so much sin that I had to go hide myself because I didn't want nobody to see. But how many of us in here today are hiding ourselves from God? We don't want to get up in the morning. We don't want to praise God.
They think they hide. They think they hide.
2 hours and 45 minutes. But we don't want to do that because we're so busy. But what if God told you today that he was too busy for you? He was too busy for praying your God. He was too busy to wake you up. He was too busy to let your arms wiggle through today. See, something that I like about this lady, I can say me. spoke life. It was something that she heard.
Come on.
And she spoke to herself.
Yes.
In this text.
Yes.
She knew that if I could just get to him. I mean, sometimes we just got to talk it up.
Yes.
If I could just get to Jesus on today. If I could just get to his
grace. Come on.
Because life and death lies in the power of the tongue.
Yes.
God spoke the whole world into
existence. Yes.
But you think that you can't talk to Jesus about your healing and your deliverance.
Yeah.
You can't talk to Jesus.
Yeah.
It was times that I was hurt so bad by things that had happened in my life that I had to talk to God about. Some of y'all know some of the things that I've been through. When I lost my daughter, 15 months ago.
Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord.
I had to talk to God about it because the more I talked to the world, the deeper and deeper I fell into the world.
Right.
I remember when I lost myself.
Come on, baby.
When my daughter passed away, let me tell you. I was into God.
Yeah.
I was deep into God. I was praising God.
Come on,
I was preaching for God.
Yeah.
I was doing everything that I thought that I could possibly do. Then when my daughter died at 16 years old and I stood there and watched her die, I said, God, why my child? Why did you do this to me?
Mm-hmm.
Jesus.
But I had to understand that if it be thy will, just like Jesus had to say, if it be thy will.
Yeah.
But I remember when I used to lay in my bed and I used to cry all night long, toss and turn, and say, God, take this from me. And then as she passed away, the devil reminded me of everything that I had been through, all the hurts that I had been through. And he started attacking my mind because I didn't speak to that demon and say, I bind you up and I rebuke you and I send you back to the bottom pit that you came from. I began to let him talk to my mind and say, what you preaching for? What you showing up for? Did God show up for you? And so the devil started twisting what God's plans for my life was. So sometimes you gotta begin to speak to that thing. When your finances get low, you don't let your finances take you out. Because bills was there before you was even born. You didn't speak to those bills. I said I rebuke you. God said I should be the lender, not the borrower. All of those things. Call those things to be not as though they were. When you got that pain in your body, don't begin to let it feel okay. Don't begin to let the doors open up in your life.
Go ahead.
And when he touched the hem of Jesus' garment, how many people know that when he had a hem, what they used to do was they used to have scriptures in the hem of their garments, of their robes. So what I was reminded of, maybe when she touched the hem of the garment, maybe it said, touch not by your anointed. Maybe it said, by your stripes I am healed. Maybe when he was walking, what she did was just get a little word. What happens if we begin to just touch the hem of Jesus' garment and give a little word? So, or maybe he just said, maybe the words were, touch not my anointing. Because she knew that she had a plan and a sign. Even though everybody around me is full of hell and all hell is breaking loose, because everybody around me is partying, killing, and clubbing, don't mean that I got to be a part of the festival. I can turn them around. I can begin to speak life into their life.
Amen.
Or maybe she touched, the Lord is my shepherd.
Come on.
Maybe she see. Eyes have not seen. Ears have not heard.
Come on.
Maybe she was knew that she was next in line for a miracle.
Yeah.
Maybe she spoke. I'm finna get a blessing.
Go ahead, go ahead.
I know what God's gonna do.
Yeah.
How can we have all of these scriptures in the Bible, but not open them up and call them back?
All right.
How can we have all of these things that's given to us? We see all of these examples, but we don't want to take it.
You know it.
God said if you will begin to press on today, if you will begin to press your way. I don't care what's standing in your way. People always going to talk about your finances. They're always going to be the way they are until you begin to speak life into them. If you want to get out your circumstances on today, begin to speak to your situation. So I'm gonna push today. When you're pushing, you gotta begin to say yes to the Lord. Wherever you send me, Lord God, I go. Sometimes it don't feel good when you're going somewhere. It doesn't feel good when you have to keep on ministering and you're tired. It doesn't feel good when God said, get up out pray to see my face. Yes. It doesn't feel good when he wakes you up in the middle of the night. And he says, get up and pray right now. All night long, lay before other people.
Yes.
It may not be what our flesh feels like, but as long as you're doing the will of God and you're about God's business, he's always going to be about your business. Yes. If only you begin to go to church like you're supposed to go to church. You say, I ain't going to church, my show up. But what if God began to take you up out of here? What if God did something to you? What if when you should have been praying, the enemy was setting up a trap for you? Because we remember in the Garden of Gethsemane, when Jesus told them to pray, they was asleep and he came back 3 times. And Jesus was up there taking this attack from him.
Yes.
He wanted this cup to be passed for him. Because Jesus was like, I'm going to die. Yes. How many people know that if you're in the presence of God, if you're praying on a daily basis, that God will begin to reveal some things to you?
Yes.
He will begin to show
you.
Hallelujah.
Yes.
They got it. The enemy got a trap for you. And begin to bind up and rebuke the enemy. Yes. Get off of me. Addiction spirit. Stronghold. Get up on me. Generational curses. Get off me. How many people know that you only begin to just push?
Yes.
And begin to just meditate on him. God will take you to a whole nother level. Even though you didn't know I'm here, let you know that maybe you're going through a storm right now. But it's going to be okay because we've been making doors for a night. But joy's coming in a morning. We don't even want to begin to get into that place.
Come on,
God. Because we don't have time.
Yes.
But God is saying on today, he wants a closer walk with you.
Yes.
He wants you to begin to talk to him.
Yes.
He wants you to begin to lay before him. He wants you to begin to seek after him.
Yes.
For his word today. He wants you to begin to fast and pray. Because how many people know some things come by fasting and praying?
Yes.
But you don't want to give up now to where God wants to take you. You don't want to give up peace.
say push.
When you feel like, oh God,
press,
I'm so excited, touch. Get up out your bed. When you feel like all hell is broken loose in your life, you need to push.
Yes.
You need to press into the presence.